Hi, it's Stacey Myers here from StaceyMyers.com, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to create checklists, PDFs and reports in Canva. Now, why you want to use these? Any of those things are great for any area of your business, but they're especially great to use for lead magnets or free opt-in offers. So if you want to give away something in return for people giving you their name and email address to build your list, these are really quick and easy options that you can use to do that. So inside Canva, you want to come down. If you're going to be creating a report, I use the one down here that says A4. So if you click on that, then it opens up here, and it's like the typical A4 kind of page size. Now, on the left-hand side here, they give you lots of different options for you to be able to use. So if you want to use any of these, you simply click on them, and they come over here. Now, you'll see some are free and some are paid for. So you can use, of course, any of the free ones for free, or if you want to pay for one, you can. Now, you can search for just the most relevant or the free ones. There are literally hundreds of them in here. You can just go down and search for one, and you'll find various checklists. Now, if you don't want this one, you can just simply click on it and delete it, the components of it, or just click the little bin here. Or you can highlight the whole thing and click delete, and it will get rid of all of it if you don't want to get rid of the individual components separately. Now, you can spend ages going through these, and the ones with the little drop-down flap here, if you click on it, it shows you there are some different pages that go with that. So it's not just the front page, it's got some inside pages that you can use as well. So just as far as checklists go, I found this one earlier that you can have a look at. So see, what's great is it's already set out with the rest of the background. So if I want to change the back here, I can just click on it and choose a different color that I want. So it gives me the colors that are inside here already, or I can choose any number of these colors that I have. This is a palette I put in earlier, which you can do with the paid version of Canva. With the free version, it's not possible to do that. But I can pick any color by clicking on the little cross here, and then I can choose any color here. Or if I know the hex color that I want to use, so if I have a particular hex number for my brand, then I can choose that as well. So for here, we're just going to pick this color. And then over here, I can start to modify this. So I can change the font. So I just click on it and I simply come over here and go through. There are hundreds of different fonts you can use. So I might want this font. And then I can make it bigger or smaller, stretch it out. I can change the color. I might want it black. And then here, I mightn't want this. If I don't want it, I can just simply click and get rid of it. Now, what I can do are things like if I'd like a border. So they have all of these other options here that you can use, that if you click on them, they're going to give you little icons and various other things that you can use, or background images. So I want to use the shape because I want to put a border on it. So I'm going to pick this border here, and then I can simply stretch it up to whichever shape size I want that to be. And again, I can change the color of that. So now we've got going to a retreat. Then you can arrange them. So it's kind of like it's in layers. So if I want this border then to go back, I can send it to the back. So now when I click on here, I have the title. So, and I want this in the middle, just like if you're using Word. So I want this in the middle here. I want it bold. Then down here, I can click on each individual one. So if I'm going to a retreat, what do I need to take? Clothes, toiletries. And then you simply click on any of these and you can change them. So I want to take my laptop with me. And again, if I don't like the font, I can change the font of this as well as the size. I can delete them. Like if I don't want this one, I can click on this individual one and get rid of it. So this is a great way to be able to make a checklist. Now, if you happen to want to make one from scratch, come back into your designs. You can click on here again. Now, this is going to be a little bit more time consuming to start one from scratch. So if we want to do one going to the beach, so I just click down the side on text. Going to the beach. And again, I can take that up the top here. If I want to make it bigger. So now I've got going to the beach, and what do I want to take? Now, the easiest way to make these is to make the little squares. So this is going to be my checkbox. So you make it to whatever size you want. So we might want to make it that size. And see, you can have all different ones down here. If instead of a little square one, you want to do like a little star checkbox, you can do that. And again, you just make it smaller. Like this. And then you can either do copy and paste, or you can click up here and it will copy it. So if we wanted to make that, like this. And you can see how it gives you the lines to help line it up. And then you just add the text. So if I'm going to the beach, I'm going to want to take my towel. And again, you just drag it into position wherever you want it to go. Now, again, if I want this exactly the same, I can just copy it. And then put them down next to where I want to go. Then you can leave it. I like to leave the checklists without very much color on them, because quite often people want to print off a tech checklist. This is true with reports as well, but so I don't do a lot of background color, because what I could do is click on the background here and say I want the background whatever color. But then when people go to print it, it's going to print the whole thing. So I generally keep the background quite light. And then down the bottom here, you can brand it for yourself. So you could put your website in there and put that down the bottom. And then if you wanted to add like any little images, or if you wanted to have a background image, so we have a free photos here. If you wanted the beach, and we want the free ones only. So I could add my checklist. And so this will take up the whole page. And then remember, we need to put it behind. So see, now just be careful when you're using images, because you can see now parts of this are a little difficult to see. And if you don't want that one, you just click on it, delete. You can try a different one. So this one you can kind of see there. So it's really a case of playing around. But like I said, I generally leave the back quite clear so it's easy for people to see. So this is a quick way to make a checklist. Now, if you want to make a report, and you can easily brand these without spending a lot of time on it. Like for me, like my design skills aren't amazing by any means. I'm getting better, but they're really not that great. And one of the simplest and easy things I've ever seen was, and I've created one of mine. I'm doing one at the moment, actually, doing exactly this. So this is it here. And so I've created the front. That was the front cover I created for it. And then that's going to go on one of these. So you can see all I've really done is, like, this isn't finished yet, but I've just put this little box at the top and branded down the bottom. So it's so simple to do. You just find a shape and then you just put it to wherever you want it to be. So it could be at the top here. I want one at the top and I want one at the bottom. So I change the color of this. So just say I wanted that color and then I can copy it. And then put it down the bottom as well. So now I have this at the top and at the bottom, and I want to brand the bottom so it's the same on everyone. So I can get my text, and I just want down the bottom my website. So let's make that white so we can see it down there. And then we pop it down here. And that's really all you need to do. So then we'll make it a bit bigger. So it could be you want to do like step one. And then you can have that up the top. Now, once you've placed what you want to have here, you can just copy this again. So if I click here and copy, it's going to copy that with everything on it. So then if I just want to change this then to step two, then I can do that going down. Now, if I want to create something different, I can click add new page. So on this one, we might go back and we might want to border again. So if I click this one, then I can make a border. So as you can see, there are lots of different ways that you can do it. Again, I want to change the color. I can add my text. So I have my heading in this report. You will learn. And then if it comes off the edges, you can just squash it in using the side bits and bring it up. And if you want the writing closer together, if you click on spacing, it changes how close the letters are to each other. And also you can bring it up. Like if you want this a little bit closer, then, so in this report, you will learn. Now, there are a couple of ways you can do this. You can either write it like in a Word document and then copy it over. Or if you want to, you can simply start typing in here. So the first step you need to take. And then just keep, you can keep typing in here and then move it around to wherever you need to. And this is literally how easy it is to create a report. Now, once you've created it, you can download it as a PDF. So you just click on download and you can do PDF print you can do a standard. So print is a little, the quality is still great. So I normally just do the print recommended one, or you can make it a PNG or a JPEG. You can pick, if you don't want to download all the pages, you can pick this particular pages you want. So then I just click download on that, and then you'll see that it's ready here. So here we have the report that we just made, and it looks really professional. It's good quality. And then for the checklist one that we did, you can download that as a PDF, or you can also download it as like a JPEG or a PNG. So you just click on that. If you want the transparent background, so if you had an image there, so just say you had this on here. Let's take her down here. And when you want this on your website, you want the background clear so you can't see. So that's where you'd use a transparent background. So let's take her off there. So if I wanted to have this as an image, then I just click download JPEG or download PNG, and then I just download it. So yeah, this is a fantastic way to be able to make your checklists, like mini reports or even longer reports, and then to turn them into PDFs. Now, below this video, I have a link. I have a checklist on how to actually think up and put together, plan out what it is that you want to have in your PDF document. So if you want to write a report, in this checklist, I go through all the steps you need to do to think about what content and everything you want in there. So you can grab that below the video. If you found this useful, I'd really love it. If you shared it, subscribe to my channel. I have a lot of other videos that are similar to this. Comment and give me a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video.